What's up, everybody? Sensei here. Welcome to the show. Welcome to another video. And I have a treat for each and every one of y'all. Remember, the video footage that you're about to see today spans between the years of 2008-2011. I will leave a link in the description below where you can go check out all this video footage in its entirety. Just follow the links. I took a deep, massive dive down into the EUC rabbit hole and was just intrigued and fascinated by what I found. It helped me connect a lot of dots, some things I knew, some things I didn't. So I'm going to just share all those tidbits and information with all of y'all. So the first electric unicycle patent was filed back in 1977 by Charles L. Gabriel. And you have to understand that a patent is active for 20 years. After 20 years, it goes inactive or dead, and someone else can file that patent. Here's another one that was filed in 2006 by Mark Cimare and Janik Cimare. Images off to the left. I was just really amazed because I didn't know it went back that far. In September 2004, Trevor Blackwell demonstrated a functional self-balancing electric unicycle using the control mechanism similar to that used by the Segway PT and published the designs as the E-Unicycle. Here's Trevor, and this is his invention right here, the electric unicycle. Trevor's a little younger here, but this is basically what we're rocking on right now. He's a little bit older here. It's a little bit better look at the electric unicycle. And here's another shot of it. And this was the first one that was developed. This is Daniel Wood. You see his credentials. He's an inventor, entrepreneur. He's the CEO of Focus Designs, but he was the first one to invent the commercial selling SBU, SBU-VT, SBU-V3. He is the one that bought the electric unicycle to the market. And I'm telling you, please enjoy the rest of the video. I'm gonna start running off at the mouth. Enjoy.
It's a power switch right here, flip it on, balances. It's got a turning kind of compensation which helps you turn it so you can kind of push it. One interesting aspect about it is the turn compensation, where if it's tilted and then twisted, it powers you around the turn so you can do really, really tight in the corner.
Are there two gyros or?
It's actually four in this one.
Okay.
I'm using three.
So it's doing a proper three axis.
I'm not doing like an initial measurement. I'm doing just what it needs.
Okay.
All kind of custom. Like I wanted that turn compensation, so I used the axis that I needed to do that.
Okay, right. Flip up. I like this much better than mine.
Yeah. Have you refined yours much since the original, or?
I don't know what version you saw, but I have one with a 16-inch, bike tire wheel.
It looks well made too, which helps.
Any other critiques, advice, constructive criticism?
No, it seems really good. I mean, I assume the charging works reasonably well.
Yeah, just a simple charger. You plug it in here. Charge for less than 2 hours.
Is it lithium?
Yeah, lithium. Lithium iron.
So what is the top speed?
10-12 miles an hour. Depends on the weight. How you ride it is you lean forward to accelerate,
yeah.
And you gotta lean back to stop accelerating and to slow down. You want to just sit on it and get a feel for it?
I do. I totally do. Oh, wow. So it's ready to go. Very clever.
So you want to get a feel for the leaning forward move. Look at that. Best first ride ever.
From riding down the street, it's not like people just kind of yell at you when you ride a Segway down the street.
Yeah.
They just don't want to hurt. They want to come out and hurt you.
I keep coming out to locations like this, so I got nice big space to practice in.
So awesome.
All right, congratulations.
Hey, my name's David, and I'm here to test out Focus Design's new flagship product, the SBU. I've never ridden one of these before in my life, but let's see how long it takes me to learn.
So I'm gonna test this out now. Probably should turn it on. Okay, I'm just gonna try to walk. I'm just gonna try to walk with one leg. Woo! Faith in the machine. Jumped up a little there. It's so weird feeling. It's a weird feeling to lean backwards with nothing there. It slowly built a relationship between me and the SBU. I'm now a hybrid. So I'm having a little trouble feeling confident with speed still. I think that's my main issue, speed and left-right balance. So I've done this little drill. Going forward, then stopping. Just going forward, stopping. It's helped out a lot. I'm noticing there is a beeping sound whenever I lean too far forward, and I think that's the torque capacity. It sends a little message to you saying, don't go so far forward. You have to remember that the work is done for you by the unicycle. All you have to do is balance left and right. I'm leaning pretty far. I'm getting a workout. It's not a Navy SEAL workout, but it'll do. See, it feels good when you can just come to a nice, smooth stop. That's one of those breakthrough moments that you look for. I'm gonna go off a ramp now, feel confident. Curves are still a little bit of a challenge for me.
As every SBU owner knows, a good day's worth of riding ends with a pushback. This is the battery indicator, which we call the heartbeat. As you can see, this light is extremely short. This means that the battery is almost dead. At this point, the rider has two options. One, plug it in and charge it for roughly an hour. Or two, find a hill. The hill option is extremely effective because the SBU features regenerative braking, meaning every time you go down a hill, the SBU is actually putting juice back into the battery. This is an extremely awesome feature, as this 3.5 mile hill just got me that much closer to a full battery.